Hello, soulful viewers. The people of Tibet would like to say Jesu Yirang Yodha to visitors, meaning a hearty welcome in Tibetan. I am Eshi. The gentle Tibetan people wish for Buddha's love and blessings to be showered upon you and your loved ones always. Tibetan Buddhism is a religion with a rich cultural heritage that emerged from a wide range of practices. These include the complete scope of the Buddha's teachings from the Hinayana, Mahayana, and Vajrayana traditions. Different schools belonging to Tibetan Buddhism today include the Nyingma, founded by Padmasambhava, Kagyu, founded by Tilopa, Sakya, founded by Konchok Gyalpo and his son Sachen Kungya Ningpo, and Gelug, founded by Tsongkhapa Lhapsang Drakpa. The teachings of Tibetan Buddhism focus on an awareness of death and the ephemeral nature of life, leading to diligence in meditation and spiritual practice. Mandalas, prayer flags, and thangka paintings are visual reminders for practitioners on the path. One of the renowned masters of this religion is Jetsun Milarepa, meaning Milarepa, the revered one. A former magician who became a yogi, poet, and hermit, this spiritual hero of Tibet lived from 1052 to 1135, and his story of personal redemption has inspired lives across many generations. Through songs called Dohas, Jetsun Milarepa imparted divine teachings on spiritual devotion and wisdom. Supreme Master Chinghai has spoken about the venerated Milarepa on several occasions, as during this lecture given in 1992 at Sihu Ashram in Taiwan, also known as Formosa.
Chang Milarepa, you can see, he because his spiritual spirit is too strong, isn't it? He's too afraid of the devil, knows that the heart is impossible, so 他的师父责骂他怎么样纪念他还是忍耐下去是吗这是因为从内心出来的我们叫他这样做也不行了没有人叫他这样做也没有人强迫他做呢是不是就是因为他从内心求道的艰辛看得出来难怪他那么成名嘛那么成道嘛像米拉热巴他成佛了以后 他还要继续修行有没有他师父教他去山洞里面修行每一个山洞不能留超过三天有没有然后我是一个两个礼拜了然后他每一次都这样都一直这样修行后来每一次他唱歌或是写什么好的诗啊他都教他 他都先尊重他的师父他那个时候已经成道了是不是不过每一次他唱课出来他还在说啊怎么样敬爱的我的什么什么师父啊先崇拜他先赞叹他然后他才讲他的故事或是讲他的诗或是唱他的歌出来啊就是印度的人也是这样传统
Today, we present to you an excerpt from the holy text of Tibetan Buddhism titled 60 Songs of Milarepa, Vegetarian. Song 2. Complimentary song to the deities of Red Rock Jewel Valley. One day, after leaving his cave to collect firewood, Milarepa returned to find five Indian demons with eyes as large as saucers, whom he thought to be apparitions of the deities who disliked him. As he had never given them any offering, he then began to sing. This lonely spot where stands my heart is a place pleasing to the Buddhas, a place where accomplished beings dwell, a refuge where I dwell alone. Above red rock jewel valley, white clouds are gliding. Below, the Sang river gently flows, wild vultures wheel between. Bees are humming among the flowers, intoxicated by their fragrance. In the trees, birds swoop and dart, filling the air with their song. In red rock jewel valley, young sparrows learn to fly, monkeys love to leap and swing, and beasts to run and race. While I practice the two Bodhi minds and love to meditate, ye local demons, ghosts and gods, all friends of Milarepa, drink the nectar of kindness and compassion, then return to your abodes. Song 3. One day, Milarepa's patrons from Drotang came to visit him. They asked him what benefits Janpan Nangka Sang had to offer. In reply, Milarepa sang, "I pray to my Guru, the Holy One. Listen, my patrons, and I will tell you the merits of this place." In the goodly quiet of this sky castle of Janpan, high above dark clouds gather, deep blue and far below flows the river Sang. At my back the red rock of heaven rises, at my feet wild flowers bloom, vibrant and profuse. At my cave's edge wild beasts roam, roar and grunt. In the sky, vultures and eagles circle freely, while from heaven drifts the drizzling rain. Bees hum and buzz with their chanting. Mares and foals gamble and gallop wildly. The brook chatters past pebbles and rocks. Through the trees, monkeys leap and swing, and larks carol in sweet song. The timely sounds I hear are all my fellows. The merits of this place are inconceivable. I now relate them to you in this song. Oh, good patrons, pray follow my path and my example. Abandon evil and practice good deeds. Spontaneously from my heart, I give you this instruction. Song 4. One day, some villagers from Ragma came to see the Jetson. They asked him, "Why do you like this place so much? Why is it that you are so happy here? Pray, tell us what you think of all these things." In answer, Milarepa sang, "Here is the Bodhi place, quiet and peaceful. The snow mountain, the dwelling place of deities, stands high above. Below, far from here in the village, my faithful patrons live. Surrounding it are mountains nestling in white snow. In the foreground stand the wish-granting trees. In the valley lie vast meadows blooming wild. Around the pleasant, sweet-scented lotus, insects hum along the banks of the stream. And in the middle of the lake, cranes bend their necks, enjoying the scene and are content. On the branches of the trees, the wild birds sing. When the wind blows gently, slowly dances the weeping willow. In the treetops, monkeys bound and leap for joy. In the wild green pastures, graze the scattered herds. And merry shepherds, gay and free from worry, sing cheerful songs and play upon their reeds. The people of the world, with burning desires and craving, distracted by affairs, become the slaves of earth. From the top of the resplendent Jamrock, I, the yogi, see these things. Observing them, I know that they are fleeting and transient. Contemplating them, I realize that comforts and pleasures are merely mirages and water reflections. I see this life as a conjuration and a dream. Great compassion rises in my heart for those without knowledge of this truth. The food I eat is the space void. My meditation is dhyana beyond distraction. Myriad visions and various feelings all appear before me. Strange indeed are samsaric phenomena. Truly amazing are the dharmas in the three worlds. Oh, what a wonder, what a marvel. Void is their nature, yet everything is manifested. Song 6, The Eight Reminders. On his way to Sri Ri to meditate, Milarepa lodged at an inn where a merchant, Dhava Norbu, the moon jewel, was also staying with a great retinue. Milarepa begged alms from him, upon which the merchant remarked that it would be better for him to work to support himself. Milarepa pointed out that enjoying pleasures now is the source for more suffering in the future. Then he said, "Now listen to my song. Castles and crowded cities are the places where now you love to stay, but remember that they will fall to ruins after you have departed from this earth. Pride and vain glory are the lure which now you love to follow, but remember when you are about to die, they offer you no shelter and no refuge. King's men and relatives are the people now with whom you love to live, but remember that you must leave them all behind when from this world you pass away. Servants, wealth and children are things you love to hold, but remember at the time of your death your empty hands can take nothing with you. Vigor and health are dearest to you now, but remember at the moment of your death your corpse will be bundled up and borne away. Now your organs are clear, your flesh and blood are strong and vigorous, but remember at the moment of your death they will no longer be at your disposal. Sweet and delicious foods are things that now you love to eat, but remember at the moment of your death your mouth will let the spittle flow. When of all this I think, I cannot help but seek the Buddha's teachings. The enjoyments and the pleasures of this world for me have no attraction. I, Milarepa, sing of the eight reminders at the guest house in Garakhache of Sang. With these clear words I give this helpful warning. I urge you to observe and practice them.